Hello and welcome to the Gray Room. Today we're going to do an unboxing of the GraviTrax Obstacle Set. Now this is strictly an unboxing video, and if you want to see the review, I'll put a link in the description below and you can go check it out. Alright, so let's start off with taking a look at the box. And this is the GraviTrax Obstacle Set. It's for ages 8 and up, and basically what it is the starter set and 5 of the expansion sets. Now, something interesting right here, it says 186 pieces. Now, let's take a look at the back of the box. Now, back here, it shows you everything that comes in the box, and it gives you a list right here. And if you add these up, that adds up to 155. But the first two are the instruction booklet and the construction plans. So that's not really counted in the pieces. And then when you count these pieces over here, it's 153. And so if you look it up, it says there's 153 in the kit. So we're going to open this up and see what actually is in here. All right, we got the box cutter. First thing we need to do is cut the plastic so we can get into this thing. Let's rip it open here. Now, I have 2 of the starter sets already, and so this should be pretty interesting to see how this compares to those. Oh, got some extra cardboard in here. Now, the starter sets didn't have things like that. So, first of all, we have the instruction booklet. And so that has, you know, it's got the element overview in there. Shows you all the different pieces. Now, here's where we get to 186 pieces that it said on the front. Maybe some extra pieces they're counting for the transfers and the zip lines. Then we have our construction plans booklet. Right, has several of those plans in there. Oh, looks like there's an extra piece here. We'll have to find out. Huh, it came out of the booklet somewhere. That's 1, 2, and 3 right there of that design. Have to find out where that goes. Interesting. Alright, so you get 2 of these clear levels. Have a bag of rails. A bag of little parts for the bridges. Maybe those add up too. This is a slow track. And those are pieces for the transfer. And we have some large height tiles. The starter block. We got 6 marbles in here. And those are for the bridges, I think. Here's some more pieces. I think those go to the transfer. Those are also transfer pieces. Got some specialty blocks. Oh yeah, these are for the spiral. And then these are some more large height tiles. And we have some small height tiles. Have another marble here. Oh, this is for the hammer or the scoop. I forget which item it comes with there. Or, oh no, that's for the zip line. That's right. Yep, and then here's the little pieces for the special tiles. And then we have, what do we got here? Oh yeah, the curved tiles. There's some more marbles. You got your three colors and then some silver marbles for things like this, the magnetic cannon. And we have, oh yeah, a couple of angled height tiles. Those are for the trampolines. And then this is for the zip line. And these are the trampolines. And then we have a couple of pieces, a couple of bags of pieces here. Not sure what those are for yet. Have to look at the instructions there. And then I know this is a thin rail. And then we have, oh, there's another bag of these. And we have four of these base plates. And then you actually do have to pluck those out of there. And then I saw something else. Oh yeah, one more clear piece. Oh yeah, this is for the zip line. Okay, so I'm not really sure where they came up with their numbers at, because whenever they get all these different pieces here that make up these, there's more than 186. And whenever you count this as one, and like that's one, then there's 153. So I'm not sure where they came up with their numbers, but there you go. And then I found out that this is not actually a page missing out of the book. So what this is there's nine track guides in here from A through I, right? And then this one is specifically for all the different expansions called the obstacle, right? That's why this is called an obstacle. So it's like an obstacle course. And they only give you one that is the obstacle course. So that's kind of a bummer, because I was kind of hoping that maybe there would be some more track ideas with the different obstacles and expansions in here. But this is the same book as the starter set. All right, let's open up our pieces. All right, so we do have four base plates that are interlocking, and you can interlock them in several different ways. We do have two of the clear level pieces. And then we'll go ahead and open up our height tiles. Put those down there. And the way they have these packaged is similar to what you would get in the starter kit. And then they package separately what you get because of the expansions that are added to it. So these are large height tiles, and you can see these are small height tiles. They're skinnier. So we'll stack these up in a few stacks here. Put them to the side. How about eight in each stack? There you go. There we go, seven stacks of eight large height tiles. Open up our small height tiles. If you want to see the difference here, these are about one half. The small tiles are about one half. So two small tiles equal one large height. There you go, 12 of those.
Then we have our curved tiles. And so they're considered curved tiles because they're curved in the grooves. So let's see how many of those we got. There we go, 21, just like it says. And then of course, there's three of the junction tiles also. Then we have these. These are for the special blocks. So there's a vortex, there's nothing else that goes with that. And then this is your 3-in-1. You can attach a finish line here, or you can leave it open and you can add it to other spots. And you have these pieces that go into these. So this is for the switch. So those clip on right there, like so. And then you have your catch. And then you have these three. And there's the finish line that can attach there. And so these you have to alternate because you only get three of these. And so that could go in there. You know, this is a ball catcher, so it's angled. You can see it's kind of angled there. So when the ball lands in here, it goes through. So put that in there. And then so you get two of those. And so we'll put this one. And what that is, that's called the free fall. It's hollow. The ball comes in here and just drops right through. All right. There we have those special ones. And then that. And then here we have the balls, the marbles. You get three silver ones, a blue, red, and a green. All right, then you also get a magnetic cannon and a launch pad, so you can launch up to three at once. All right, so that's all the basic stuff. Oh yeah, so forgot the rails. So we got the rails here. Pour those out, it should be three long ones. Yep, there's three long ones, six mediums. Yep, and nine small ones. Yep. 3, 6, and 9. Okay, we'll move this out of the way a little bit, and then we'll check out the expansion stuff that gives you the obstacle course. Okay, so we'll start with the bridges. These are all the little pieces that make up the flexible bridge part. There should be 12 of those. Four for each bridge. You get three of them. Yep. And then these are pretty hard to see if I put them up here. Okay, so that is a long slow track. And this is a long narrow track. The marble goes pretty much the same speed or maybe even a little faster on that one right there. So those come with the bridges. And then we have the base plates for the bridges. There's three of those. And then you also have marbles to go on in the base plate. That kind of gives it a little weight for when the bridge is extending. So they go in there like that. Right there. So you need six of those. So there you go. So then we'll put these together here. So you got to have the right ones. together. And they go like that. Get another one. Like that. And then where's that instruction booklet? How do we hook it to the base plate? Comes right here. So it says we use this part. And gotta do it this way. You let that come through. Looks like that's what it says. That you have to snap that in there. There we go. All right, like that. And it needs one more. Whoops. Gotta put that one more in the middle. I put the end on there already. There we go. And so that goes like that. When the marble comes down, it extends out to connect over to another piece. So there you go. So that's one of those. All right, I'll put the other two together and then we'll check out the next thing. All right, next we have the trampolines. And for some reason, the angled tiles are in a Ziploc bag, maybe so you can put them in there and keep them separate. You can see they're angled, so that gives you, when you put them on the trampoline, that will angle it to bounce over like that. So you have two of those. There we go. And then let's look at the spirals. So there's two spirals. And then there's lots of pieces with those. So the instructions for the spirals are here. And we have one of those, and it looks like there's three different types of spiral pieces. So there's that one. There's that one. And then there's these. So it says to start with one of these, put that in there, then we get one of these, that clips in there, it says you do five of those, so there we go, that's two, that's three, that's four, and that's five. And then the last piece is one of these. So then that clips in there, and then that's gonna hook to the next track. So there we go, I'll build the other one, and then we'll take a look at the transformers. All right, so after getting these built, there are actually two different size spirals. This had five, and this one had seven of the little half connectors that you had to put around it. So these are the transfers, and so you got to put those together also. So we have Ziploc baggies for these, and so we have three of these pieces, three of these pieces. Then we have these little clear arms. There's three of those. And then we have three of the tiles with three little armature pieces in there. It says this goes in there like that. Can't get it snapped in. Oh, there it goes. Got it. Okay. And then this piece goes on the bottom to keep that in. It's getting stuck in there again. There we go. It looks like it goes this way. Okay, I got that one. And you gotta kinda put it into the side first and then get it snapped down in there like that. So then you're gonna put this arm in it. And there's very hard to see, there's a flat side, and you stick that, there's a little groove in there, and so that goes in that groove. So you do that with each one of those. And you have the little arm to flick the transfer. And then on the instructions, it says to make sure that it's the right way. Right. Goes like that. So that when the marble hits it, it's going the right direction. There's an angle to it. So you gotta. But there's a flat side to the pole, and so then there's a part in that, so should be able to get it on the right way anyway. Set them up like that, and then the ball will transfer to each one. All right, so the last thing we have is the zip line. Oh yeah, I did want to mention too, it came with three sets of arms extra for these transfers. So let's open up this for the zip line. You have two bases, two risers, you have a marble, an armature piece, and the little part that goes on the line that slides down right there, and then this the actual line piece. So we have a marble there, and that goes in there. And then here's the instructions for that right here. Shows you how to clip each one of these on the end like that. You have this one like that. Right. You have the marble in there, and then this part goes together like that, so it can kind of hang on there. And then these go into the base plates. Oh, there is a little groove. Oh, there you go, me trying to force something together. Good thing I didn't break it. There you go. You got snaps in. So then one marble would sit and get one of these out here. Oh yeah, so one marble would sit like that, right? And it is, that would slide down and whoop, knock the marble off and start it on your next one. And so, you know, this needs to be up so it can slide. So, and it tells you right here, the max differential is, if this is on a flat surface, 3 large height tiles and 1 small height tile. That's the max differential for that. All right. So there you go. That's the unboxing. That's what's in the kit. Looks like a pretty good amount of stuff. So if you want to see the review and a track made with it, then check out my other video. The link will be in the description below. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.